Hello guys, welcome back. So in this video I'm going to show you how to make a custom function in Excel. So what is a function? So suppose I type 1, 2 and make this till 10, and then if I say equals to sum, sum is a function. See, all these are functions too. So I'll type sum. So now what does sum do? If I put a bracket and I select all these and close the bracket, it says 55. So what is 55? It is the total of all these numbers. So now I want to make a function which converts liter to milliliter, and the function's name should be lm. So if I type lm, there is no function called lm. So now you'll have to go to the developer tab. After that, right click the ribbon, customize the ribbon, and then your developer tab will be unchecked. So check it and say OK. So now it should come. After that, click Visual Basic, then Insert, Module, type Function. And after that, you should name your function. So my function will be ML or LM. That's right. Liter to milliliter. So open bracket, close bracket, Enter. So now in the brackets you should type a variable name. So a variable is where you are going to enter the value. So I would prefer naming the variable name close to the thing you are entering into the variable. So I'll say liter, because I am showing, so they have to type a liter and I'll convert it to milliliter. So after that, say s and then integer. After that, you will have to say lm equals to L-I-T-R-E, liter. LM is the function's name, liter is the variable's name. You can make more variables by putting a comma and then again making a variable. So for this I need to leave 1. So liter into 1000. So even if you go to Google and say liter to milliliter, the formula place will say multiply the volume by 1000. So I'm multiplying it by 1000. So after that, I'll just copy all this. And now if I say equals to lm, there's a function called lm. And now I type 1 liter is 1000 milliliter. I say 5 liter is 5000 milliliter. So now if I close Excel and say don't save, and I open it, I don't see the function anymore. So now I'll do the same thing I said to do. And I had copied it, so I'll paste it. And then what you'll have to do is save it as a Excel add-in, not a normal Excel workbook. to be Excel add-in. Then it will go to a file location. And I prefer naming the file's name of the function's name. And my function name is lm. And I'll say save. So after that, I'll close this and say don't save. I open Excel. And then I still don't see it. That is because I have saved the add-in, but I have not added the add-in into Excel. So what you have to do is go to File tab, Options, Add-ins, and then my add-in's name is LM. So then press go. Then check LM and press OK. So now if I say equals to LM, there's a function called LM, and even if I close the laptop or shut down the laptop and open Excel, it will still be there. So now if I want to remove the function completely, I have to go to File, Options, Add-ins, LM, go, click on LM, click on Browse, and then copy the path, and then uncheck LM, and click OK. Go to File Explorer, and then paste the path. So now I'll delete LM. And now if I say equals to LM, LM is no longer there. So if it helps you, please hit the like button and the subscribe button. So thank you. Bye bye.